Hello friends, welcome back to our channel. So in the last video we had discussed how to update the firmware using the LBFS system. So in this video we will go further. We will discuss about the firmware update manager, how to refresh the firmware update manager and to fix LBFS metadata error. What happens is sometimes the GNOME store will throw this LBFS metadata error. It will show that it is not able to fetch the updates from LBFS system. So how to fix this metadata error? So it is sometimes it is a bug, sometimes there might be a network problem. So whole in whole, the system will not be able to update the Linux firmware. So to fix this problem, what we have to do is you have to open the terminal. First you have to give a firmware update manager version, so it will show the current client version. Right now it is 1.5.7 in my laptop. You did not worry about this compile time dependency versions. Daemon version, okay, it will be same in most cases. Now from here it is important, you have to give the command firmware update manager get devices. The devices will be enumerated which can be updatable. So the first is my touchpad, Elan touchpad. Second is my Toshiba hard disk HDD. It shows the device flags. It is an internal device. My hard disk is an internal device. It is updatable. System requires external power source. Needs a reboot after installation. Device is usable for the duration of that. Both the devices have this device flags. So what does that mean? They are internal type of devices. They are inside the system. So that is the body of my motherboard. They are put inside. They are not external devices like USB drives or pen drives. They are updatable. So in the older generations of devices, the firmware used to be non-updatable, but nowadays it is updatable. The system requires external power source during the update and for regular running also. Needs a reboot after installation. So these two devices will require a reboot after installation for the new firmware to start working. Device is usable for duration of the update. So while the device is being updated with new drivers, the old drivers will continue to work and provide support for the normal working of the laptop or PC. So after this, the second command you have to give is firmware update manager space double dash force space refresh enter. So this will connect to the LBFS repos. Now they will check the versioning and everything, and if there is some updated driver is in the LBFS repository, it will be downloaded, it will be installed. You have to restart the system this time both Elan touchpad and my Toshiba HDD requires a reboot after installation. That's it. Sometimes some devices will not require a reboot, but these two devices for right now they require a update, so we'll have to they require a reboot, so we'll have to reboot it. So after completing the download and installation, we have to reboot the system. The new firmware will start working. Thank you very much. Please do subscribe to our channel, support us, and give us valuable feedbacks. Thank you. Bye.